much of a game changer do you think the iPad is?
Well, I think it probably is an enormous game changer. As always, people say, oh, you know, it's lacking this, it's lacking that, it's lacking the other. Games aren't changed overnight with one launch, though to some extent, this arena, the space between the laptop and the portable mobile smartphone, was changed instantly, because the moment Apple announced the iPad, even before the launch of it, all kinds of companies were making claims about their slate or pad that was coming out. Most of them proved to be actually just dreams and disappeared with the mist. Apparently there was going to be an Android this, a Windows 7 that, a whole new this. HP's bought up Palm. They're going to now bring out a webOS-based device. But you know, the fact is, all the other companies are maneuvering into a position where they create something like the iPad. And to me, that's good. You know, I loved the iPhone, but it never because I wanted Apple to have a monopoly on smartphones. What they did was they utterly changed the world of mobile phone communication, completely changed it. And the result has been the development of the Android system, a very worthy rival to it. Palm had their go with the webOS, which didn't work out for Palm, but HP have bought them, and it still probably has a future. Even Windows have finally been forced into creating something usable and likable in their 7 system, 7.7 system, mobile 7 system, whatever they're calling it now, and I'm sure it'll be excellent. I mean that. So it is. It's about enriching the environment in which these devices exist. It's not about Apple thumping down with elephantine feet and creating some monopoly, and I would never want them to. And actually, the fact is, the Apple iPhone has a tiny percentage of the market. It's merely that it's utterly influenced the entire way we do it. And that's traditional with Apple. I remember back in 1984, before you were born, when the Mac came out, it was not unlike anything anyone had ever seen as a consumer, you know, what were then called microcomputers. But it took a long time. It took you know, Microsoft 8 years to come up with Windows to look like it. And then suddenly everybody then had a mouse and you know, icons, and it was the obvious way to go. Well, Apple is still doing that, but you know, it's no longer 8 years; it now tends to be 8 months. You know, the speed has increased. But you know, listen, Apple can make mistakes. You know, the history of tech of the last 30 years has shown that gigantic companies can come to nothing at enormous speed. You have to continue to innovate. You're never the leader; you're always just ahead, and someone is overtaking you. Look at what happened to AOL. Look at what's happened to Microsoft. And it could happen to Google, and it could happen to Apple. They have to keep it because it's a really amazingly fast and fluid market.
Absolute Radio is one of the few UK websites to move over to HTML5 already. How much of a problem do you think the issue of Flash is for Apple?
I don't think it's a real problem at all. I think people have been rather misled about that. If you have an iPad, yes, there are sites where you can't see the Flash content, but obviously, If it's a YouTube, then that's fine. That works perfectly on an iPad. BBC allows, there is a BBC app that allows all its content to be viewed. I think it's, you know, Steve Jobs and his colleagues at Apple are in it for the long term, and they're probably right about Flash. And even if Flash improves so that all the criticisms are no longer valid, then Jobs will have made his point. As it stands, Flash is processor greedy and battery greedy in a way that, you know, does make the experience less good. And I know this because I have, you know, all kinds of Android devices, and I avoid using Flash on them simply because, unless it's plugged in, it's just too expensive and wasteful.
Here we are, another huge Apple launch.
Oh, he's got it.
Are we going to see another event like this? What's going to be next? A prediction for the future?
God, I wish I could. I have absolutely no idea. I'd love to know. I mean, you know, we're all looking forward to 3D printers becoming more affordable and things like that. But I guess things like the more things built in, like light projectors, for example, and you know, that'll come. I mean, we're all looking to the iPhone.